Now, to be clear, I was hesitant on seeing this film based on its premise alone, but I will give it the benefit of the doubt because of the fact that they fixed his design for the character. I'll explain about that later on in this review, but for now, let's gain some speed and get this review over with, shall we? Is up my Cinedroids, G to the S here. Today, I'm gonna be reviewing a live-action CG hybrid kids movie based on one of the most beloved video game characters made by SEGA, Sonic the Hedgehog. Starring the previously mentioned well-beloved said video game character of all time, played by Ben Schwartz, who tries to navigate the complexities of life on Earth with his newfound best friend, a human named Tom Wachowski, played by James Marsden. They must soon join forces to prevent the evil Dr. Robotnik, or as many of you would pronounce it, Dr. Eggman, played by the master comedian himself, Jim Carrey, from capturing Sonic and using his powers for world domination. Of course, the same old cliche, right? Now, here's the thing. I did watch the trailer where they messed up his design about almost a couple years ago now. And yes, I'll admit his design looked horrible. But to be honest, I was not that angry at it as the internet was. When I saw it, I was like, yeah, I'm not really that surprised. Could have been a lot worse. But yeah, I thought the trailer looked generic and dull rather than appalled and pissed off than some of you are. But we're not here to talk about his messed up design from the first trailer. I'm here to review the darn thing with his more improved design. Short version? It was cute. Long version, let's discuss the basics about it. First off, the CGI was used really well. Mostly it's on Sonic the Hedgehog the character, but of course, he's the main character that you're supposed to root for throughout the entire movie. But at the same time, when this movie shows you other worlds, it's really fascinating. First, you go to Sonic's home world, then this movie shows you the Mushroom World. And no, I'm not talking about the one from the Mario Brothers franchise, okay? I mean, he might make a possible crossover with Sonic maybe in the near future as far as I'm concerned, but still, keep out the comments, okay? But anyways, the beginning and end part of this movie, in terms of story and plotline, to be 100% honest here, kind of reminded me of the beginning and end monologue from the movie Megamind a little bit. Don't know what that is? It's basically this cliche in movies where we cut to the latter half of the movie for the intro, and then they reverse the whole movie to find out what happened before that, to get into context about his adventures to foil Dr. Robotnik from taking over the world and all that jazz. Yeah, it's all familiar stuff, but at the same time, at least it's a simple premise. Dr. Robotnik is taking control over the universe, and it's up to Sonic the Hedgehog to save the day. That's it. But I enjoyed it. It was executed so well. Props to Paramount for keeping it simple rather than making it cluttered and all over the place. Take notes, Illumination. I also thought the amount of camera work and cinematography was not really that bad either. Especially the movie's amount of action sequences. They look so cool. Especially when you see Sonic speeding his way through, I'm assuming it's New York City. If it's not, let me know in the comments. But it does feel like I'm watching an action sequence from The Incredibles a little bit. You know, that whole sequence where Dash is speeding from Syndrome's goons on those drones that have spinning saw blades on them? Exactly! It's that fun to watch! Kudos to the boys at SEGA for keeping us engaged with its amount of action sequences and good quality camera work. Keep up that pace, guys. I also thought the direction from Jeff Fowler wasn't that bad either. It really gives a whole new meaning to the term CG hybrid. The only CGI character that gives the most attention and focus is Sonic himself. And to be honest, Ben Schwartz did a fantastic job portraying him. He really did embody the characteristics of the speedy hedgehog, which he obviously is. But at the same time, he has this childlike innocence to him that you can't help but see him as a cute character who has a goal to achieve and needs to overcome the odds against him, particularly taking down Robotnik. But at the same time, now moving on with the negatives of this film, according to the movie's amount of comedic timings and humor, some of his childlike antics resort to generic jokes that were not really as funny as I want them to be. Like, for example, I mean, I get it. It is a movie based off of the video game. You might as well have fun with the new concept for Sonic. But for me, in typical Hollywood fashion, they resort to blatant pop culture references that didn't work for my taste. Like, obviously, there's a Star Wars reference in there. But there's also a reference to Spider-Man's classic signature advice from Uncle Ben. You know, the "with great power comes great responsibility" speech. References like that are the reason why this movie ceases to be special at this point. But hey, that's just my take on it. That's all. With that said, guys, in the end, the Sonic the Hedgehog movie wasn't the best movie ever made, for sure. It's a kid's film. What else did you expect? But it also doesn't mean that it's one of the worst movies ever made either. It had potential, it had the right amount of heart, the characters were a lot of fun to watch, especially Jim Carrey as the main villain for this movie. He's always great to watch. And the adventure aspect of it is not that harmful for kids whatsoever. Kids can have fun with this movie. I'll take this over any generic kids film that's out in the mainstream any day. So I'll give Paramount that. As a result, I rate Sonic the Hedgehog, the movie, 3.5 stars out of 5. Not a bad rating. It's still a safe movie that the young ones can enjoy. But still, it's not like it's one of those movies that I can run to the store and get the Blu-ray copy of it while it's on sale, is what I'm saying. I'm glad I saw it for myself. That's all that matters. So the Sonic the Hedgehog movie, have you seen it? If you have, let me know in the comments what you thought about it. Was it good? Was it bad? Answers down below, please. Also, if you like this video and you want to see some more, make sure that like button shines in your face. That'll totally help me out a ton. Also, share that video with your family and friends and favorite it. That's a very good way to show support for this review. Also, if you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe and ring that bell right next to you so you can be notified of future videos that I have in store for you. Also, if you want a shout out on a future video, just follow me on both Instagram and Twitter and I will choose one of my Cinedroids to be displayed as a shout out. The link's in the description below. And also, follow me on Stardust so you can catch early reactions of movies, TV show episodes, and trailers. I'll put a link to that below in the description as well so you can download the app for yourself. But until then, I'll see you next time. Peace out.